policies in your platform. One of those that might be different from your other candidates is the idea of mental health issues and changes to the football ticket pool. So if you'd like to address those two and any other issues that you think, from a policy standpoint, set you apart from the other candidates.
When I speak in organizations, I always say that football ticket pool is something none of us understand, and I think probably most everyone in this room can attest to that. Football ticket pool is so confusing. If you look at it, it's probably one of the smaller points on my policy. I'm not going to say that it's as important as the campus master plan, because quite frankly, it probably isn't as important to our student body. But if you look online, there is not a single bit of information about how the ticket pool process works. And our students deserve that. Mental health awareness and funding is incredibly low on college campuses across the state of Texas. This is something that we are not just facing here at Texas State. Funding is low, and quite frankly, for a population of 58,000, we need more funding and we need more resources for students.
Jason, in your platform, you talk very specifically about sexual assault in the Greek community, as well as the 25 by 25 plan in the engineering college. If you'd like to address those two parts of your platform and any other specific policy initiatives.
So, I'll start with the 25 by 25 policy. I've been hearing from multiple engineering students that this isn't something that they want, that we're growing, our student population is growing way too fast compared to our infrastructure. And this is a really touchy subject, and this is something that I didn't know if I really wanted to take a hard stance on. But after hearing every single, a lot of students' opinions on this issue within the engineering school, I decided someone needs to take a stance on it. There's not a single student that I have talked to that point. As far as sexual assault and sexual harassment goes, there have been multiple incidences and multiple cases throughout the nation, specifically within Greek communities, of sexual assault and harassment happening, and things that have actually happened here. So I want to raise awareness for it, not only within Greek communities, but within the school at large. And you just do that, one, by reaching out to different organizations, making it more aware, getting testimonies from students, letting people know that this is something that happens.
Kevin, two of the specific policies on your platform are the creation of the Student Athlete Commission and the implementation of 30-minute fasting periods. Can you speak to how the Student Athlete Commission is different than the existing Student Athlete Council and address the what you believe to be the practicality of switching to the 30-minute fasting period?
With regards to the Student Athlete Commission, I feel like it's really important to have the individual within student athletics to be representative of the student government specifically. And in addition to that, within the executive cabinet as a whole, I feel like student athletes take up a lot more of the student population than we even realize. Of course, the biggest sports out there get the most publicity, but we fail to realize that some of the individuals who are in the lesser known sports that perhaps we don't pay as much attention to deserve just as much attention as well as care and what we need to be doing for them as student athletes who represent the university. And then on the topic of passing periods. One of the reasons that I was looking for this is I'm sure a lot of y'all, like myself, have classes on one side of campus and you got 3 minutes to deliver across campus to the next one. So one of the benefits of this is one, I'm not having to sprint from point A to point B, but also give you some peace of mind that you can make it safely and also make it in time to perhaps go over your notes and making sure that those